Good morning, I am Devasena. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about signal flow graph solved problems, part 1. This topic is present in the subject control system. Here, we are going to solve two problems related to the signal flow graph topic. Problem 1. Find the closed loop transfer function C of S by R of S for the signal flow graph shown below. Here is a representation of the signal flow graph. For this signal flow graph, we have to calculate the closed loop transfer function C of S by R of S. Here, the input signal R of S is applied to the summing point S1. And from that, the signal is applied to S2, and from that it is being applied to S3. And from S3, the signal is applied to T1. And it is being taken out C of S, and the path is having that its own path gain that is indicated in this signal flow graph. Identifying forward paths. Forward path 1, F1 is equal to G1, G2. The forward path 1 is indicated here because in this problem we have only one forward path that is indicated in this diagram. Identifying loop gains. First individual loop gain P suffix 11 is equal to minus G2 H1. The first individual loop gain is identified here. The second loop gain, individual loop gain, is P suffix 21. Its value is minus G1 G2 H1 H2. The second individual loop gain is identified here. The third individual loop gain is P suffix 31. Its value is minus G1 G2 H3. The third individual loop gain is identified here. Identifying two non-touching loops. Sum of two non-touching loop gain products. It can be easily identified from individual loop gains. Select combinations of two loops which do not have in common. Just multiply the gain of the combination. Similarly, identify all possible combination of two non-touching loops and sum up all gain products. In this problem, we do not have any non-touching loops. So, sum of P suffix M2 value is equal to 0. Similarly, in this problem, we do not have three non-touching loops. So, the value of sum of P suffix M3 is also 0. Calculating delta and delta 1 values. Delta is equal to 1 minus sum of P suffix M1, because in this problem we have only individual loop gates. We do not have two non-touching loops and three non-touching loops. Therefore, we can calculate the value of delta as 1 minus summation of P suffix M1. So delta is equal to 1 minus, if you substitute the values of summation of P suffix M1, that is three individual loop gains we have to substitute, P11, P21 and P31, that is delta is equal to 1 minus open bracket minus G2 H1 plus minus G1 G2 H1 H2 plus minus G1 G2 H3 close bracket. That is delta is equal to 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1 G2 H1 H2 plus G1 G2 H3, because we have taken minuses common from these elements and already minus is available in the outside. So minus into minus plus, and the value of delta 1 is equal to 1 because all the loops touch the forward path 1. So we cannot eliminate the loops. Therefore, the value of delta 1 is equal to 1. Calculating transfer function value C of S by R of S. C of S by R of S is equal to F1 delta 1 divided by delta, because in this problem we have only one forward path F1. For that forward path F1, we have calculated the value of delta 1 and we know the value of delta. Substitute the values of F1, delta 1, delta in this above equation. we get CFS by RFS is equal to G1, G2. This is the value of F1 into 1. This is the value of delta 1, the whole divided by open bracket 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1, G2 H1, H2 plus G1, G2 H3. This is the value of delta. This is the final answer for this problem. Signal flow graph problem 2. Using Mason's gain formula, find closed loop transfer function CFS by RFS for the signal flow graph shown below. Here is a signal flow graph. In this, RFS is the input signal that is applied to the T1, which is having a gain of 1. From the T1, the signal is applied to S1, which is having a gain of 1. From S1 to S2, we have a gain G1. Between S2 to S3, T2, we have G2 gain. Between T2 to S3, we have G3 gain. Between S3 to CFS, we have gain 1. And this is the given signal flow graph. For this signal flow graph, we have to calculate the overall transfer function CFS by RFS. Problem 2. Calculating forward paths. Forward path 1, F suffix 1 is equal to G1, G2, G3. This is the representation of the first forward path. Forward path 2, F suffix 2, that is equal to G4. The forward path 2 is represented here. We have identified two forward paths in this problem. Calculating individual loop gains. Individual loop gains for this problem 2 is P suffix 11 is equal to minus G2 H1. That is the first individual loop is represented here. Second individual loop gain P suffix 21 value is equal to minus G1 G2 H2. This is represented in this diagram. Identifying two non-touching loops. Sum of two non-touching loop gain products. It can be easily identified from individual loop gains. Select combinations of two loops which do not have in common. Just multiply the gain of the combination. Similarly, identify all possible combination of two non-touching loops and sum up all gain products. In this problem, we do not have any non-touching loops. So, sum of P suffix M2 value is equal to 0. Similarly, in this problem, we do not have three non-touching loops. So, the value of sum of P suffix M3 is also 0. Calculating delta suffix 1 and delta suffix 2. Delta suffix 1 is equal to 1 because for the forward path 1, all loops are touching, so we cannot eliminate these loops. Therefore, the value of delta 1 is equal to 1. But delta 2 is equal to 1 minus open bracket P11 plus P suffix 21 close bracket, because for the forward path 2, these loops P11 and P21 are not touching, so we can eliminate these two individual loops from the forward path 2. Therefore, the value of delta 2 is equal to 1 minus open bracket, put the value of P11, its value is minus G2 H1 minus, put the value of P suffix 21, its value is G1 G2 H2 close the bracket. Therefore, we get 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1 G2 H2. Calculating delta value. Delta is equal to 1 minus open bracket P suffix 11 plus P suffix 21 close the bracket, because in this problem we have only the individual loops. We are not having two non-touching loops and we are not having three non-touching loops. So we can calculate the value of delta as delta is equal to 1 minus sum of P suffix M1. So the value of delta is equal to 1 minus open bracket output the value of p suffix 1 that is minus g2 h1 plus put the value of p suffix 21 it is minus g1 g2 h2 close the bracket. Therefore the value of delta is equal to 1 plus g2 h1 plus g1 g2 h2. This is the value of delta. Calculating transfer function CFS by RFS value. CFS by RFS is equal to F1 delta 1 plus F2 delta 2 whole divided by delta. Substitute the values of F1 delta 1, F2 delta 2 in this above equation. We get CFS by RFS is equal to G1, G2, G3 into 1 plus G4 into open bracket 1 plus G2 H1 plus G1 G2 H2 close bracket the whole divided by 1 plus open bracket G2 H1 plus G1 G2 H2 close the bracket. This is the value of the required transfer function CFS by RFS. Thank you very much for listening this lecture. For further updates, kindly subscribe this channel. If you like this video means kindly share this video to your friends. Thank you.